God is good all the time. All the time, God is good. Welcome to this virtual worship service within the sanctuary of the First Congregational Church in Williamsburg, Massachusetts. In this time of being apart because of the deadly virus, we are delighted that you are with us, and we hope that you will stay well and be safe during this troubling time. Our help comes from God, who made heaven and earth. If God were not with us, we would be swept away. God has gifted each of us in unique ways. We complement each other with our variety. As we gather in worship, may we rejoice in God's love and faithfulness and be open to God's transforming spirit.
Today I will be reading Exodus 14:19-31 and 15-20-21. The angel of God was going before the Israelite army, moved and went behind them, and the pillar of cloud moved in front of them, and it took its place behind them. It came between the army of Egypt and the army of Israel. And so the cloud was there in the darkness and lit up the night. One did not come near the other all night. Then Moses stretched out his hand over the sea. The Lord drove the sea back by a strong east wind all night. The sea turned into dry land, and the water were divided. The Israelites went into the sea on dry land, the waters forming a wall for them on their right and on their left. The Egyptians pursued and went into the sea. After them, the Pharaoh horses and chariots at the morning watch. The Lord in the pillar of fire and cloud looked upon the Egyptian army and threw the Egyptian army into panic. He clogged the chariot wheels so they turned with difficulty. The Egyptians said, "Let us be free from the Israelites, for the Lord is fighting for them against Egypt." The Lord said, Moses, stretch up your hand over the sea so the water may come back upon the Egyptians, upon their chariots and chariot drivers." So Moses stretched his hand over the sea, and at dawn the sea returned to its normal depths. As the Egyptians fled before it, the Lord tossed the Egyptians into the sea. The water returned to cover the chariots and chariot drivers. The sea and the water returned. The entire army of the Pharaoh that followed them into the sea, not one of them remained. But the Israelites walked on the dry ground through the sea, the water forming the wall for them on the right and left. Thus the Lord saved the Israelites that day from the Egyptians. The Israelites saw the Egyptians dead on the seashore, and Israel saw the great work the Lord did against the Egyptians. So the people feared the Lord and believed in the Lord and his servant Moses. And the prophet Miriam, Aaron's sister, took a tambourine in her hand, and all the women went out after her with tambourines and dancing, and Miriam sang to them, "Sing to the Lord, for he has triumphed gloriously. Horse and rider he has thrown into the sea."
Thank you.
two, for those whose lives and property have been in jeopardy because of the wildland fires in the West Coast. We also pray for all those who, for 6 months of social distancing, has become a numbing isolation. May we find ways of letting them know that they are not alone, letting them know that we are all in this together. So we pray in the name of Jesus Christ, who taught us this prayer, to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen. Now in Christ's name, be safe, be patient, be strong, be loved in this time of uncertainty and turmoil. And find ways with which you can use your God-given gifts so to be the reason that someone else can be relieved in good people.